Don Undine, who is the Maker Hub manager, was familiar with the Vatican's Technology Council. So when he became aware of the Vatican Hackathon, he was telling us about how wonderful this would be to build a team here at Georgetown. Because of his connections in the Maker Hub, knowing people from all around campus, we started just getting excited about the possibility of Georgetown being involved.
I knew that the Georgetown students and the broader Georgetown community would be an amazing participant in this first of its kind event.
We decided Georgetown as a Jesuit institution has not only a lot of understanding of the refugee issues, but also about working jointly or working across all of the capabilities of the university.
One of the major advantages of the library and why it played such a crucial role in pulling all of this together is its interdepartmental, cross-disciplinary mission.
And so what we did was we put out a call across the university for students interested in this. The requirement of the hackathon was that you have a team of only five and that it be three programmers, a generalist, and then a designer.
I was the programmer on the team.
I was one of the programmers in the Vhacks team.
So I was a programmer on the team.
I was the designer on the team.
I was the general person on the team.
The students were super prepared to take on the work themselves. They said, we got this, we're going to have a meeting next week, we'll figure out what we need and get back to you. And so we had lots of resources available.
Mentors are really awesome. I mean, Don is really a person to bring everything together to make it happen. And then Holly is really the hand behind us to support the whole team.
What's nice was that the students got very clear themselves. They wanted to design something which was practical, which was going to be useful, which was going to potentially make a difference.
So the prompt we were given was to focus on refugees and migrants, and specifically within that to look at the issue of integration.
But the team prepared a lot leading up to the experience. We had a lot of planning sessions where we developed some different things that we thought were important relating to the migrants and refugees issue.
The night before the hackathon started, we paid a visit to the Sacred Heart Basilica, and this was at the basilica that is directly across from the train station, Termini, where refugees first arrived to Rome from all over the world. So our group was able to meet with refugees from dozens of African countries from all over the Middle East to really hear about what concerns them, what were their greatest challenges, and from these conversations, the students told me that the idea from creditability was born.
We all joked afterwards that though we did months of research and we spoke with refugees in DC and on the phone and experts and all these different things, our idea was a product of the night before.
One of the things we were immediately struck with was a lot of these refugees, the kind of resilience they showed in starting to rebuild their lives, but the barriers they still faced were mostly from just the inability to prove they were reliable, credible people. And that just seemed so crazy to us that these refugees had managed to start earning some form of income and were finally at that point where they could kind of get back on their feet, but they were just unable to do so because they couldn't convince someone like a landlord that they could actually make rent payments, even though they had started finally earning the money to be able to do that.
That was an eye-opening problem, that you can still like be on the brink of pulling yourself up on your feet in a new country, but not being able to find housing simply because you don't have credibility.
The first night of the hackathon, we talked for probably 4 hours, just iterating over the idea and figuring out what we thought worked and what didn't.
The product we designed is really unique. This is not anything in the market yet.
So Creditability is a website that allows refugees and migrants to input all of their financial data. Usually they've only been in the country for a short time, and it allows them to build up sort of a very basic credit profile.
We developed an algorithm that took all the information that they were able to provide to output a credit score. And we based this on how traditional financial institutions actually develop credit scores, but it was meant to be more compassionate towards the specific context of refugees.
And then we're hoping that we can partner with institutional backers to provide them with housing lease guarantees.
It felt like a good strategic alignment, and it made sense with our solution to endow the connecting partnership between refugees and the faith-based institutions who would sort of adopt this credibility product.
the overall aim would be once that refugee gets access to that first lease and is able to show that they're actually able to make rent payments, then they can build up their credibility score over time and get access to a whole host of other services, like maybe even employment or other things, basically just building up their credibility in their new country.
It was kind of weird. We didn't actually think that we would win. In our final round pitch, I was one of the two people, me and Rashika, gave the pitch.
I was like sweating bullets, watching like our team present and then waiting for the winners. They announced the number two, and like with me and Holly are just like, and then they announced the number one, and I just went, yes! And I like pounded the table. I think I stood up.
When we actually won, we were all so exhausted from not having slept the night before that I think it was kind of overwhelming.
Just a lot of cameras flashed, and then we took our hilarious novelty check back to our seat.
Don and I were like, new parents or something, jumping up and down, and it was a very exhilarating moment.
Our mentors at the Halcyon House reminded us that gratitude is really important on a team, so we went around and thanked each other and also talked about the future.
After Hackathon, we, as our team, we don't want to just like stop the project, we want to just like keep the project moving.
Since the idea was produced on basically no sleep in 36 hours, what we really want to do now is get a chance to talk to folks in the space and understand what are the gaps in the model we've developed, what are the potential challenges, what already exists that we could potentially partner with, and hopefully make it a reality.
In addition to asking people for potential financial backing, we also want to work with organizations that are already working with refugees to sort of stress test our idea.
That to me is really exciting, that it's not a one and done, but something that is, we're at the beginning of what I hope is going to be a real project that has real impact.
There is the potential to truly change the world by working with students of all different backgrounds, all different disciplines, all different religions, to truly draw upon their education and their values to use technology to create this revolution of mercy that Pope Francis called for.
I shouldn't say I'm most proud of them winning, but that was pretty fabulous. I was actually most proud of the way they worked together.
I think one of the best parts about the experience was that it really was a team effort.
How to work with other people, how to work with, you know, group. And then this is what made the Hackathon experience really awesome.
It was working with the team that I think was the most valuable experience. Also getting to go to the Vatican for their first hackathon.
Massive thanks to Georgetown for giving us this experience. It was an amazing opportunity. Could not have ever imagined any of us would be there. We took a lot out of the opportunity, and yeah, it was a great experience.